Hello there. In this video, I'm going to show you the basic of very basic of file manipulation. So in order to do so, I'm going to code a small program and show you an example of what I mean as I could. Let me start that right away. So open terminal, code test.go, and as usual, a package main. Function main, and let's start with the declaration of a file that we will read thanks to the OS package that we will open thanks to the OS package. I will show you what I mean right after. So the name of the file will be sample.txt. Where does it come from? Actually, it doesn't exist, so I need to create it. I'm going to put it in the same folder, echo, and I'm going to put a word in it. Echo hello in sample.txt. Let me make that right. There we go. So now, if I save this, there should be a mistake because there's a multiple value with this method. This means that I have to deal with those multiple value. I put a comma here, and the second value is actually an error. So if I don't want to deal with this, I'm just going to do this, and I can go on and on. But for once, I'm actually going to show you what it means. So let's write error, and let's deal with this. If the error is different from nil, let's show what the mistake does. In order to do that, we're gonna print it. Print, and then actually, oh, I'm gonna put F. The mistake is underscore. Let's put the value backslash n. And how do we access this error? We do it this way. Error. There we go. So now let's check what it does. This should work by itself. Right now, I didn't use the file, so let me print it. Let me put its stats. Println file that stat. There you go. Okay, now this is a working program. Let's go run it. A lot of new notion right now, but this is normal. This happened. We actually printed the stats. There's actually no error because it found the sample text. Let's say I change this. I forgot the E. So that file doesn't exist. Let's run it. The mistake is, no such file or directory. So see here, it found the mistake. So this is something that you need to keep in mind when you're writing Go, the multiple value returns and the errors. You haven't used it much at this point, but it will come on. Now let's continue with the file manipulation. Let's do a read of that file. File.read. That method takes a slice of byte. So in order to do so, we have to declare it. So let's call it array. Let's do a make a slice of byte. And how do we know its size? So in this case, let's do an ls that la the size is actually 6. In this case, for the sample text, so I can put a 6 here. fileread the array. That's it for now. Now I would like to see what I just read. println, and in order to do so, I'm going to put this, but as a string, need to cast it. There you go. This should work. The mistake is, no, this didn't work because I still didn't fix the mistake. Let me fix that. And let's test the program. There you go. So the first line, the stats are appearing. And here's the content of the file, the sample text. This is thanks to the read file and the println I just did here. Now, last thing, but a very important one, and it's a very good practice. You need to close the file. So what you do is that you put this method. It won't have much impact. Sorry, I forgot to see uppercase. It won't have much impact in your exercises right now, but it could have some in the future. When you deal with database or stuff like this, it will impact the performance and the used RAM. So this is a good practice. Every time you open a file, you need to close it. So that's it for now. And I wish you good luck with your next exercises.